Well, the film Band-Aid premiered to rave reviews at Sundance. It's a film that tackles the trials and tribulations of marriage. Welcome Zoe Lister-Jones and Adam Pally. Good morning, you guys.
Good morning.
Good to see you.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
All right, so tell me, we've seen so many versions of marriage on TV and film. What makes this different?
Jews.
In addition to being Jews, this couple chooses to fight through music. So they start a band to try and sort of overcome their marital squabbles.
And how does that work out?
It helps.
It
totally helps them move through. I think music is really cathartic, and there's like 9 original songs in the film.
Which, by the way, you did the whole score, you directed this, you wrote it. You're a real slacker.
I didn't do the score, but I did write some of the music. I took on a lot of hats for this one. It was really fun.
And this is your first time directing, right?
Yeah.
How did you like that? Is this something you want to do more of?
Yeah, I loved it. It was amazing. It was a really gratifying experience.
Now, let me ask you this. Well, actually, I want to say you guys are both married.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But actually, Adam earlier told me that he was a swinger, and he
I didn't say swinger. I said we have an understanding if you wanted to get a drink.
Oh. Which I totally believed him, and now I don't, so I was totally gullible.
I was kidding, obviously, but if you do want to get a drink, I can set up an arrangement.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
You know, how does, do you think marriage is an outdated concept?
I think that what I wanted to explore in this movie was just like what it means to really commit to somebody, whether or not that's through the institution of marriage. I think why couples choose to stay together is a really, confounding sort of thing that I think everyone grapples with, and so this movie really deals with sort of the banalities of commitment and the work that a marriage takes.
Let's take a look. I want to actually see a clip of this. This is a clip from Band-Aid.
Hey, Dave.
Hi, Dave.
Is that John Mayer over there?
I just
found my old guitar from high school.
Are you John Mayer?
Right. Yeah. Second time's charm.
Second time. Yeah.
What are you doing?
We're cleaning out the garage to make it a rehearsal space for starting a band.
For a band?
Yeah.
I used to play drums in high school.
Cool.
Yeah. Really?
I was in a band myself.
Oh yeah, what was it called?
The band was called Myself. It was a sort of solo percussive group.
I love the awkward pauses. You guys actually had to learn learned how to play instruments for this, right?
Yeah.
I learned how to play bass. Adam knew how to play guitar.
I knew a little bit, yeah. I knew I'm about as good a guitar player as you can be around a campfire. But as you start going further away from that setting, I become worse and worse.
He's very good. He likes to be humble. But we did play all the music live in the movie, so we had to actually rehearse as a band.
Yeah, that was it. And that has been so fun and fulfilling. We've played a couple concerts, which is like crazy fun to play like a rock show.
We have an EP that drops today on iTunes.
Oh yeah,
really?
Fabulous. Our band is called The Dirty Dishes.
Okay,
and
it's super cool to be able to say to you that. Our album dropped today.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Well, the other thing too I loved about this, Zoe, is you had an all-female cast.
A crew.
And exactly, was that because you felt like women were underrepresented in the filming world?
Yeah, absolutely. I think I was looking to create opportunities for women in departments where they are not often afforded them, and I also just wanted to see what it would feel like for women to make work together in that environment, and for women to kind of feel their most confident selves in the workplace.
And Adam, so a lot of times you were one of the only males on
most of the time.
How did that go for
you? It was great.
Yeah.
It was great. Both a really enlightening experience, because I was able to kind of feel it from the other side.
Mm-hmm.
And it life-changing in that way. And I just want to say to every woman, I'm so sorry for how horrible men are and how horrible we continue to be. And that's on us. And
this is from a man who literally just hit on the woman interview.
Yeah.
So I want to just be clear that he really is sorry, and directly to you.
Yeah.
Yeah. I accept your apology.
The apology starts here.
First of all, I didn't hit on you. I was reciprocating some vibes.
Oh!
Wow. Secondly, oh, my God. KTLA, this is getting
right,
real.
Right.
Secondly,
you felt it.
Secondly, I will say that also it was super inspiring to see all these women in such amazing positions that you normally don't see. And it gave me a lot of hope for my daughter that she doesn't just have to be an actress or in the hair department or in the makeup department. She could, you know, be a great DP. She could be an amazing lighter. She could be the number one gaffer. And all of those positions are super important, and they don't just have to be run by men.
Fabulous. I'm still feeling this heat between us.
I know.
FYI.
It's okay.
Should I go?
Just FYI.
Yeah, Zoe.
I'm kidding.
Yeah, Zoe,
thank you guys
you
for coming
go.
In. Fantastic. It is out today in select theaters, including ArcLight Hollywood and the Landmark Theater. Plus, it's available on video on demand June 9th, and it dropped today.
It dropped.
Dropped.
Dirty Dishes.
Dirty Dishes.
Dropped today.
Dirty Dishes.
Dirty
Dishes.
Thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.